Hi friends, in this video we are going to see how to create multi-platform Docker images or multi-platform container images. I'm going to use Docker Desktop to create multiple platform images or multiple architecture images of the same code that I'm using. Let's get started. Now, before we go and generate the image, let's try to understand why do we need to have a multi-platform container image or multi-platform Docker image. Nowadays, we have a lot of hardware and there are different types of processors and different architectures followed by these processors. When we publish our code as a container image, we should be able to deploy it to any of these platforms. Let's first try to understand why do we have to support multiple platforms or multiple architectures of the images. Within the Docker itself, the default Docker builder that comes up with the latest version or recent versions of Docker Desktop, if we run the Docker and then build X and we list what are the supported builders, here we can see that we have two different drivers or two different types of builders here. One is the default one and the currently used one is the desktop Linux. And under the platforms, we can see that it is supporting Linux / ARM64, then RISC-V64, PCC-64LE. These are the different flavors or these are the different architectures under the Linux itself, processor architecture that Docker images can be built, and the current builders support all this. We also see that there is the AMD64 and AMD64V2. Since I am running the Apple M2 Mac processor, it is using the ARM processor or Linux ARM64 architecture. So when I pull the images from Docker Hub, it is going to pull the relevant image or respective image which is related to my platform. If I publish my own container image and I want to support multiple platforms, that is where we have to build an image in such a way that it can be deployed or it can be run on multiple platforms. Let's first go and see how do we verify or how do we identify that a particular image or a particular repository is having multiple architectures. Now, I have this TechTalks consumer, which was published about 1 hour ago, or the version of a Docker image was pushed to this repository in Docker Hub about 1 hour ago. And it has multiple tags, depending on what kind of language I'm using for this same code base. If we go into Java here, we can see that it has under the architecture, OS and architecture, there is Linux AMD64 and Linux ARM64. We can also see this by going into the tags, and under the tags for the Java, we see there is the ARM64 and AMD64 versions of the image. There is not much size change in between this. It's just about 1 MB, but because these are different two processor architectures, we can still use this same image on these respective platforms. Now let's go and see how we can create this kind of image. I'm going to use a different repository here or different code base. I built the earlier image for TechTalks consumer, which is the cloud native Java example that I'm using, or cloud native Ninja project. You can look at the playlist to understand how to build different types of images or what is this particular cloud native Ninja project doing on this particular channel. It's a repository or it's a series of videos which talks about how you can build cloud native applications using different technologies which are relevant to the cloud native world. So I'm going to go into this source folder, SRC Java, and the name of the project I'm going to refer is TechTalks Producer. If I want to build multiple images, or if I want to build image for multiple platform, I can use this buildx with Docker, which enhances the build capabilities of the Docker tool or Docker Desktop or Docker engine. And we provide some flags like build and push. And the thing that makes it possible for us to build multiple platform images is this platforms flag or platform flag. And we are specifying all the platform for which we want to build this image. In this case, I'm specifying Linux / AMD64 and Linux / ARM64. And then I provide the tag and what is the Docker file and what is the Docker context for this. When I hit enter and when I execute that, we will see that it triggers the build using that particular Docker file. While the build is happening, we can also go into Visual Studio and have a look at the TechTalks producer Docker file. So in this Docker file, you can see that I'm not specifying anything additional. It is a standard multi-stage Docker file or multi-stage build, which uses a build stage for building the project or building the source files. And then it uses a runtime version of Eclipse Tamarin base image with Java 17 JRE as the focal. That's the base image. And then we copy the artifact or the jar into that and we publish it on 8080 port. So it's a pretty standard Docker file. Using this same Docker file, I'm able to produce two different platform-based images or platform-related images. The build is succeeded and we now have the layers pushed. So we have this image named as Nilesh Kule Tech Talks producer, and it is tagged with this Java as the tag. So if we go back into the Docker Hub and we refresh this list of repositories, let's go into the repositories tab and we see about 1 minute ago this TechTalks producer was published. Similar to the TechTalks consumer, if we go into the tags, now we would be able to see the latest version, the Java, which was published about 1 minute ago. The tag is now supporting these two platforms, the AMD64 and ARM64. So using this buildx, we saw that it is quite easy using the same Docker file that we were using before. By passing this flag as the platforms, we can generate multi-platform images. So in case you want to try this out, the command is here again, and you will find this in the description of the video. Thanks for watching this. I hope you found this useful. If you find these videos useful, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell so that you get notification when the videos are published next time. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence. Thanks once again for watching this.